ain't swallowing nothing yet, bro.
You feel like you can't, you
know,
you're swooshing around your mouth
because,
you know, let it go.
I feel bad.
Okay.
I'm trying to clear my...
Why are you shaking like that?
I have no idea.
Is your nerves? Yeah, no. Okay, come on, tell me the story about what you got.
So in the morning, my girl, they let me see after my workup right before I go into surgery.
Okay.
Right before I go into surgery, they tell you, you know, how, you know, Brenda came down. That's my fiance. They like, your fiance's on the way down. And I said, I'm waiting on, because Tree bed was right next to mine.
Right.
So he was supposed to be getting the same thing done to him like a couple minutes before I left out the room. So I was waiting on him to come get in the bed. But he walked up and came hollered at me. And you know, he like, nigga, you always laughing and shit. I'm like, dog, you know what's going down, you know what I'm saying? I got you, you know what I'm saying? That nigga was like, dog, he grabbed my hand, man, and was like, man, this is 100, dog, I love you, man. That nigga shed tears, he started crying and shit. He like, man, I love you, man. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, nigga, just make sure you take care of my kidney, nigga. That's like, you know, okay. But he was like, you know, and I seen him and I was like he, then he said, and he told me he was scared. He was scared. I'm like, man, don't be scared. Don't be scared. You know what I'm saying? You know, we gotta have faith in, I got faith in what I'm doing because I put God first on this, you know what I mean? And he brought me here. So he gonna bring you through too, you know, let's have God first. I just seen a different side of me. That's all.
That's what's
right at that moment. You know what I'm saying? I seen a different side of me. I'm like, yeah, dog, you real. Cause he meant it then. You know, when you talking about, I got you, dog. I got you. He meant it. And his mama, it was different, you know, just seeing, I wish you'd have seen that, you know, just captured that. Cause she was like, you know, I only had one son. And I thought I was going to lose my son. My son was dying, you know. And you saved his life. You know, you gave him another life. Now I got two sons. And literally, I got two sons now, too. You know, I got another son. My son's going to live and my son. You know, and I'm getting another real son. And she was like, she said, I ain't nothing. But whatever I can be, I'll be for you. You know, and I was like, I love that. You know, I ain't got my mama here. My mama ain't standing up over me, helping me through this. So it meant a lot to me. That she was happy too.
That's real nigga shit though.
Yeah, real 100.
You know what I'm saying? You, I mean, real. You know, me, my personally, I know you a good nigga. You know what I'm saying?
Real 100 shit.
Bro. And I always told everybody that I don't give a fuck what another person say. This nigga right here is a real nigga. No matter what anybody say, he's a real nigga, man. A lot of niggas wouldn't put themselves in this position, but you did. And you didn't. You not doing it because
you looking for nothing. I don't want nothing.
You just your blessings gonna come with. You know what I'm saying? That's the main thing.
Everybody need to do this, dog. There's people out here. Look, I go to my homeboy Rob house last Friday after leaving here on my workup.
You all right, man?
Yeah, I'm just hurting for that. Last Friday on my workup, and I leave here, and I go to my homeboy Rob's house, and you know I haven't seen him and his wife since they got married last year.
Right.
So when I come in, he like, nigga, what you got them band-aids on your stuff? You know what I'm saying? I have band-aids on my arm from them shots, and they're taking blood from me. I'm like, man, I'm giving them for kidney Wednesday. You know, in 5 days basically. And his wife just start crying. And she hugs me. And I'm like, what's wrong? You know what I'm saying? It's a good thing. She said, after I got married last year, I came down with diabetes. And I need a kidney. You feel me?
Right.
You see how close-knit this shit is? Hypertension and, you know, blacks that need this stuff. I know now since I've been in, I know 4 or 5 people that need kidneys, man. And I'm going to be an advocate on trying to help people give to them. Help somebody. I'm going to be all right. I'm going to show you I'm going to be all right. I'm going to show you. Then somebody go out there and help somebody else. And don't do it expecting nothing. Because the expectation is that God's using you as a vessel to bring a blessing to somebody else. You know what I'm saying? You are God's blessing. Bless somebody with it, you know? And I believe that, man. Because I told her, I said, had it not been for him, I just walked in the room and gave it to her. You feel me?
Right.
And sometimes you gotta be like that, you know, real shit.
It's just good, man. He met somebody like you, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know?
You know, and it's, you know what I'm saying? It's not like, you know, you just, you are somebody to somebody. You're not just a reason. You're not a season. You are meant for somebody. God works in mysterious ways, and he puts people in your life for reasons. And I always felt like, you know, it was just a reason. It wasn't for that. You know what I'm saying? It was a reason for it. I felt like that, though. I really got to do it, though. I felt like, you know, I've always been giving to people. I'm a giver. And this is the best gift I can give somebody, gift of life. Lay down your life for your brother. That's in the Bible. It's the most, you know, honorable thing you could do. Yeah, that's cool, bro. But I'm glad. I just wanted to make sure he get out. He all right. Because, you know, I don't want it to be in vain. I hope that, you know, everything is good for him. And so far, so good. So far, so good.
Yeah. So what did your kids, how did they feel about the situation?
What's
some of the things you've been hearing since you've been, you know, you was going to do this for this, you know?
Well, you know, you crazy. Is you crazy? What about your kids? What if your kids gonna need them? Don't do it. How much you getting for this? You know, how much is you making money? You know, I wish I could have had people around to say that then. I mean, somebody to take that, because that was funny. Mouth dry. Wish I had people around to say that then. But like I said, and then, you know, real is real on the outside of it. Because like my boss, he's like, man, don't you want to change your mind? I'm like, no, man, you know. He's like, but on the flip side, when I walked out that door, he hugged me and said, you know, you a good man for doing this, you know what I'm saying? You one of a kind, you know what I'm saying? That's just a great thing that you're doing. And sometimes it'd be so great, people can't fathom the thought of it, you know what I'm saying? If you could do it, would you do it? You know what I'm saying? If you could do it, save somebody's life, would you? You know, ask yourself the question sometimes. You could do it, would you? I would.
Yeah, we know you would, but you did it, you know? Right. So right now we check, you know?
Yeah.
Back to asking, how you feeling, man?
Like I said, I'm hurting. I mean, I'm good. My spirits is good, but I'm still in a lot of pain. Still a lot of pain. Where my hat at? Since I ain't got my hair done, I look like a damn sick crackhead or something.
You is a sick crackhead, but I'm about to fix you up. Now
you're
not with
us,
Ludacris.
Gangsta.
Right. So how they was treating you since you've been up here, man?
Man, my service was good. I had a bad point last night, man, like between... The service changed over at 7. And I got a new nurse and a new PCA, which is a nurse assistant. They supposed to come in and check my vitals every hour.
keep my urinal and stuff clean, make sure I need anything. But I had two chicks come in last night, man. They introduced themselves at 7, and I ain't see them again till 9. And I'm talking about, I woke up, I was on fire as far as, I was hot as hell, I had a headache, my neck was hurting, I wasn't sure whether it was complications.
Tree was hot too.
You know, so I wasn't sure whether it was complications.
He had a rag on his forehead.
And I had a towel on my head last night.
But his temperature was down, was regular, it was normal, but he was hot.
Yeah. So I had some problems with him. I had to call, I had to get another person, and I wanted to talk to a supervisor because I felt like, you know, I was being neglected. And I'm scared in here, right? Like I said, I'm in a room by myself, so there ain't nobody in here. And I hit the button and the nurse don't come? That don't make sense. You know what I'm saying? I hit the button and the nurse didn't come. And when she came in here and like I was getting on her damn nerves.
Wow. Damn.
And you know, it bothered me, you know what I'm saying? It bothered
me. Then you didn't tell me she dismissed herself.
What?
She took her own name off?
Yeah, she was like, you know, she came here and, cause she knew I was ready for somebody else anyways. You know, so I wanted somebody else. I'm like, nah, I don't even want to deal with you cause you, she went on point. Man, she handed me my thermometer, dog. Talking about, let's take my own temperature. You seen that lady just come here and take my temperature, right?
Yeah.
She put it in my mouth. It takes every bit of 7-8 seconds. She gave it to me and told me to do it. And I was like, what's this all about? You know what I'm saying? And then the other chick, you know what I'm saying, she's probably taking my blood pressure. She gonna ask me, do I have high blood? I'm like, ain't that what you doing? Why is you asking me shit you supposed to be doing right now? And then the nurse, my nurse, she has to ask me questions to get set up for the night. Like, you know, how she's going to treat me and what type of medication, what type of eyes she's going to keep on me. And she waited till about time for her to go, and she asked me about 25 questions in a row. And like, all right, and left. My service was bad, man. Another young lady came in. Two black girls came in and recovered, the white girl and the black girl. And they was much better. Cause like I said, I was used to getting
catered
to it better, you know what I'm saying? And I thought that's how it was supposed to be, and they threw me off with that shit. And like I said, man, I felt bad. I felt bad about saying it, man, but you don't know how I felt about being in here like that without no help.
Exactly, and you just doing what you just did. You
yeah,
know?
You know, I just felt like anything could have happened. I could have been, my shit could have been bleeding out. I was scared, dog. I was scared, and I wasn't feeling good, and I was feeling like something was wrong. And they just came here talking to me like, relax. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Don't tell me calm down. I mean, fuck you. You know what I'm saying? Y'all, you supposed to be on your shit. And then I tell her, you know,
she said she had other patients.
Yeah, then she say, like I said, I asked her for the Tylenol. Take her 45 minutes to come back with a Tylenol, dog.
Hey, what I just heard with the other doctor.
Yeah.
Said
it's on the floor. She lied to me and said they had to send it up. She lied to me, man. You know what I'm saying? This is serious about how I'm feeling in my body. She telling me a lie to just try to tie me over for a minute. And that ain't cool, you know what I'm saying?
What's that in here?
This is a pen. They give this to me from the Living Donors wing in Harper Hospital. This is a two-sided pen. Living Donors have given the most precious gift imaginable, and that's a gift of life to someone. And one side says, I have given the gift of life. And the other side says, I have received the gift of life. And we both gonna rock these, you know, as a symbol of what we've done. And as advocates, because we as people need to really get out here and help somebody else. Get out here and help somebody, man. Don't just, you know, there's people out here dying. Yeah, pay
for it.
Pay for it, right.
Good words. That's what I was thinking. Pay it forward, man. Because we are all we got. Really. People are doing this everywhere, but black people ain't doing it. And we need to do it. If you're not going to be a living donor, sign the back of your license and be a donor in death. You know what I'm saying? Help somebody win. Cause what you going to do with it? You dead now. Help somebody. And, you know, there's other small procedures and stuff that people can help other people. And just knowing about it and not being scared to be able to, you know, step out of your comfort zone and actually help somebody, man. I don't do this for no monetary value. I don't want a dollar for nothing. I don't want no data boys. I want God to know that I'm a vessel and he can use me as help for somebody else. And that's, you know, that's my big thing. That's all I want to do. Let people know, man, God is, you know, everywhere. And you can help somebody. They gave me another keychain, too.
Ear thing. And a wristband. Bye-bye. Can't get it out. And it says...
Donate life.
Donate life.
That's what's up.
That's what's up. Cause somebody's gonna be better because of this. And it's funny cause you know, my man, he didn't know I was gonna give him no kidney.
Exactly.
He had no idea. I looked at him, I didn't know anything about diabetes. So I asked him about it. Like, what is it? Where's it come from? Kidney failure. I didn't know what your kidneys did. I knew I had some. But I didn't know what my kidneys... I didn't know my kidneys purified, held my teeth and my skin and all the things. I didn't know none of that. But he was... I seen him going through some difficulties. We got children the same age. He has a daughter, I have a son. They hang out. And I just... asked him one day, I was like, you know, what do you need? What can help you? Can you be helped? You know, I hear a lot about cancer survivors and, you know, they got chemo, but what do they do for people with kidneys? They go to dialysis. Ow. And,
forever.
Forever. And die on dialysis. If they don't have a kidney, you just die. It shortens your life every time you're on it. So, I asked him about it and I said, well, where do I go? You know, if I wanted to see about, check about giving, donating a kidney, where do I go? He said, well, you gotta go to the Harper Hospital. That's where I'm registered at. So I told him I'm going, and he didn't believe me. So I called him one day when I was down there. I was like, guess where I'm at? I'm at Harper Hospital, man, figuring out how to give you a kidney. Came down to Harper Hospital, you know, to check on about, you know, finding if I can be a match for, you know, my friend, to see what I have to do, you know, just walk me through what I need to do to see what I have to do to be a kidney donor for my friend. So when I get down there, you know, they want to make sure that you're healthy first. They take your blood pressure, and then they send you through like a, you know, like a class, like an orientation. Give you an update on, you know, let you know what your kidneys are, what they do, what failing does to you. And like I said, it was an education to me because I didn't know about that. I've been blessed to be, you know, without any problems, without any health problems. I'm healthy, you know, so I didn't have any idea of what he was going through. So I got educated on, you know, his disease to the point where, you know, they took some blood. And maybe a week or so later, they gave me a call and they was like, well, you match. And I was excited about it, you know what I'm saying? But I didn't want to tell him myself because he didn't think I was even down there. He didn't think I came, period.
And when he did find out, you know, he just, you know, people talk a lot, you know. People say a lot of things that they're going to do, and people promise all type of things they would do for somebody. But it's just the fact that me and this guy wasn't, you know, we weren't the bestest of anything. It was just somebody, we knew each other. And I knew him to the point where we had a personal conversation, and it touched me to the fact where I said, I'm going to go check and see what I could do. So they told me it matched, and I told them to call him. Let the hospital call him. So when the hospital called and told him that, you know, he was a match, he would know that I actually did it and went through what I did. So this process started in January. It is now like August 17th. And all year long, I've been going back and forth to the hospital with different appointments, what they call workups. They take blood, they take CAT scans. I hadn't been to the doctor that much in my life, you know. And on the flip side, I got an opportunity to see how well I was, because they weren't gonna take something from me unless I was healthy. So me being healthy was good news that I got out of, you know, all the workups and things. So, what's this? 8 months later. It came to the time, it was here. It's time to go into surgery and give my man a kidney.
So how do you feel about you doing it?
I mean, I feel like it's something I was destined to do. Right. I feel like, you know, I've always been a giving person. You know, I've always been a giving person, and if it wasn't for him, I probably would have gave it to somebody else if I'd have talked to somebody else that needed it. And I think people should feel like that. You shouldn't, you know, if it's not my family or my brother or something, it could be somebody else's brother. It could be somebody else's son. You know, it don't have to be your son. It could be somebody else's son. And fortunately, I helped a woman who only had one child. And, you know, her only child was dying from this illness. And I helped save her only child. And I'm blessed. I love that, you know what I'm saying? That's cool. Who you know wanna give help save somebody's life. If I'm a role model or be a mentor or something, if I wanna show something to my kids and tell them something good, that's a story I'm gonna tell my kids. Like, look, you can give more. You can always give more to somebody. Help. Don't be selfish.
It ain't got to be the money to
use. It ain't about no money. It ain't about no perks. It's not about it. Like I said, I don't want a data boy, a slap on the back. You know, I appreciate being acknowledged for what I did, but even in real, I'm a religious person, so God said, if you give something, you don't stand up saying, I did it. You know what I'm saying? That's not cool. Why? Because, I mean, somebody else didn't do it. They couldn't do it. You know, just be one of the people that said, I tried. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And I tried to do something. And it worked out for the both of us. You know, I'm healthy. I'm good. I'm here. I'm going to be all right. And he's here. And he's going to be all right, too.
They got a hair transplant you can get?
That's what you should have. If so, you had it already.
Right, I need to give it to you.
You give me that good.
So, how did his mom feel when you told her?
Well, she was very, you know,
emotional,
ecstatic, you know.
Yeah, she was emotional when I was there.
I'm trying to think of what words to say. Just overwhelmed with, you know,
joy.
I guess that's what, it's best joy and, you know, a little bit of fear and hoping that everything, you know, that out. Everything was going to be all right. You know what I'm saying? She didn't want nothing to happen to me because I was healthy. And she didn't want nothing to happen to her son because, you know, he was already going through something anyways. So the ordeal, you know, the surgery itself, it lasted a long time, but the surgeon said he just took his time. You know, which was cool because, you know, I'm fine. You know, the next day I got up and I walked around and then when they put my kidney in him, it worked. Instantly, he had a super kidney. It just started
pen, man, and started peeing, and that's what he's supposed to have. And it's that kidney started working for him, so it's going to change his life. He won't have to be in dialysis no more. He won't have to worry about what he eat, and, you know, it's...
He's still going to have to worry about what he eat, though.
I mean, you know, not to the point where it's going to affect him...
daily.
As much. You know, as much as cautious as he was by watching it.
Because he wasn't peeing at first. Right. He had all that waste to stay in.
Yeah, so he's going to lose weight. He's going to lose weight. He's going to live a healthier life because of his kidney.
You that's
know,
what's up.
Yeah, so, you know, and that's, I think that's cool. You know what I'm saying? I'm learning more about it as I go. And, you know, the more I learn about it, I'm like, that's cool as hell. You know, I think that's a blessing. And I think that's a blessing. Everybody, I think people need to do it. I'm going to be an advocate for it. I want people, you, to go out there and help somebody if you can. Don't be afraid to help somebody. You know, just...
I got to see you heal up, friend.
Right. You know, I'm gonna be healed. I got a friend of mine. Well, I met a guy during this process. He gave his brother a kidney, and he was in this same bed a week ago. And I seen him. I came up to see him while he was like, you know, these are what your sutures and stuff gonna look like. This is what this is how you gonna feel.
Big shouts out to him.
You know, big Dorian Ward, you know what I'm saying? Shout out to you, man, you know, cause you reinforced my faith in knowing that I was going to be all right. I knew I was going to be all right. But when I seen that you came through as strong as you did, I knew I was going to be well, too. You know, I didn't have any doubts about doing it at all. None. No second thoughts. I was going to do it. From the time I said I was going to go down there, I said I was going to do it.
That's what's up.
So, what else? I got a mother, and I got a brother, and she got her son back healthy, and she got another son. So we are now a new family growing, you know, through this process together.
That's what's up.
Attached by blood.
Attached, yeah. Real blood brothers.
Yeah, she told me.
Real blood brother.
She was just emotional. She was like, I owe that man my life. Because he saved my only son. And that's the most beautiful thing that ever happened to her. That's what she personally told me. And she couldn't even really talk to me while she told me.
Yeah, because I know.
She was so filled with joy and so filled with emotion.
And, you know, I know, you know, I gave Tree, you know, I was going to give him that. He, you know, everybody knew I was going to give it to him. But I knew that the day before, I mean, before we went to surgery, I seen something in my friend that I had never seen before. You know, he was thankful. You know, he was very thankful. And he was scared, you know, about the process. And I told him it was gonna be all right. And, you know, I would do it for him again. If it was another lifetime, I'd do it again. Don't worry about it. We gonna be all right. I got faith, man. And I believe that God's gonna take care of all of us.
Process
that
you've
been through.
Just tell the people a little bit, like some things that they
had
to go through.
Man, I've been through a lot, man. It was a blessing. She saved my life. She gave me a kidney. I'd have still been on dialysis.
I'm
trying not to cry, bro.
I feel you, though.
Shit means so much to me, dog. You know?
That's what's up, bro.
We need more black people to do stuff like that for each other, man. To help each other. You know what I'm saying?
Right. Man, he just did it just because of the kindness of his heart, and he felt like a friend really needed.
Out of the kindness of his heart. I told him I was sick, told him what I was going through, and he was there to help me. And here I am.
That's what's up, man. You can relax, you can relax. Well, this is, that is definitely a blessing.
Yeah.
They said, I heard as soon as they put the kidney in, it automatically started working.
Man, it started working immediately. Before I even woke up, I was using the bathroom and everything. You know? I feel great, I'm not in pain. just been a, you know, my life, I'm getting my life back. Right. I've been down for 2 years, and I'm back.
God sent you an angel. He definitely sent you an angel, bro.
Definitely.
Especially just talking to your moms when she was saying, it was just a blessing because you was her only son.
Yes.
And Shima did a favor by saving her only son.
I mean, I don't got no brothers or sisters. I didn't have no brothers or sisters, but I got a brother now.
You got a brother now, baby.
He put that kidney in me.
Got a brother now. Got a brother now.
He gave me this. He got the other half, and I get the other half. I'm going to keep this the rest of my life. You know what I'm saying? I mean, I'm emotional right now. It mean a lot to me for what he did for me, man. You know, I had people that I knew 30 years didn't even offer to even get checked. And he never once hesitated. He was there from day one. When I told him I was sick and what I was going through, he was like, I'm gonna help you. And he didn't back out on me. I love him for that. My life is back. No more dialysis. I take my meds, stay in shape, I'm gonna be good. You know, it's hard for me not to cry because it means so much to me, man. My life is changing overnight again. It just went from bad to good again. You know, so excuse me for being emotional right now, but it is what it is. Man, it's been a long road. Probably got a little more road to go through, but everything is good right now. I'm doing good.
Okay. Hey. That's a good cry though, man. You know what I mean? A happy one. I'm happy for my brother. I'm happy for my brother. And like I said, I want other people to do the same thing. If you can, help somebody. And don't be afraid to try. Help somebody.
That's even if you know. Like, all you got to do is just sign your name on that driver's license. Man.
Driver's license, man. You ain't got to do it while you living.
That's all you got to do it.
Even help somebody in death.
If you look at it different, man, all you got to do is just be a donor. You know what I'm saying? You can't do nothing when you gone, so you might as well just be a donor, man. Help somebody, like you said. You know what I'm saying? If you can do it, do it. You know what I'm saying? This is like motivation. You might never know. I might be in the hospital the next weekend trying to do the same thing just because. It's a difference. I see my man, he's still healthy. He's still here. They both still here. You know what I'm saying?
And, I'm going through some pain, but it ain't nothing like the joy I feel for what I've done for my brother. What I'm going through ain't got nothing on how happy I am for what I did for him, period. You know what I'm saying? I'm happy for him. Hey, we both got kids, and our kids gonna watch each other grow.
Exactly.
We gonna watch our kids grow, and he ain't gonna miss a day of it. As long as I got something to do with it, he'll be around. And I mean that.
This man, is
these tears talk. Of joy. Tears of joy, man. I'm happy right now. I'm happy what he did for me. He didn't have to do this, and he did it out the kind of his heart. He didn't ask me for anything. He did it because he wanted to help me. He knew what I was going through. We need more people like that, man. If you could help save somebody's life, do it, man. We as black people, we need to stick together and help each other, man. Stop killing each other and help us, man. You know what I'm saying? Help each other. If you can donate an organ and save somebody's life, do it. All it takes for you to sign the back of your license. I'm doing it. If I can save somebody's life when I die, I'm doing it. You know what I'm saying? Just think, one day it might be you that need that organ. How would you feel if everybody turned you down or didn't nobody even try to help you? You know what I'm saying? That shit means a lot, man. You see me crying? I'm crying. These are tears of joy, man. I get my life back. I got a second chance at life. You know what I'm saying? Shit's not easy. I've been through a lot. Dialysis is not easy. It takes a lot out of you. It shortens your lifespan. But he just gave me my life back, man. You know what I'm saying?
It's a blessing. It's definitely a blessing, man. That's cool.
That mom's over here. Yes.
Mom's just, you know.
Yes. Tears of joy.
Yeah, that's it. It's just some things you just can't explain, man. You gotta just let God explain everything for you. You know what I'm saying? It's a lot of emotion going on right now in this room, because it's really just, like you said, tears of joy. Everybody happy right now. You know what I'm saying?
Everybody.
And I just know he meant to be dialysis down there all the time throughout the week. You know what I'm saying? So it is a blessing. He got his life back, you know what I'm saying? And he got a brother now, you know what I'm saying? My man Sheem is officially his brother.
We blood brothers, man.
Blood brothers.
Real talk, they all had the same symptoms, so you know, that's gonna be a stupid ego. You know, you might just see Tree be a different person one day because he got some of this, you know what I'm saying? Some of my man's kidney in him. And it's gonna be,
you know, hot.
It's gonna be, you know,
get his picture in too, yeah. So.
We family, you know.
We family,
what I'm saying?
For life, man.
That's
gonna see
up.
Us together forever.
That's what's up, man.
Ever.
Yeah.
It's my brother from another mother. My brother from another mother.
I'm gonna get some of this.
You know, understand. We both in pain right now. But he saved my life though.
I love this man. Again.
I
yeah.
love him.
You know, son, it's nothing.
They make it so bad the operation is smooth. You know what I'm saying? That's another blessing. They ain't have no problems throughout the operation. It went smooth. Like, you know what I'm saying? This is if the operation went right, it could have been possible something wrong with it would happen, but God was there. God was one of the doctors helping them put all that
walk
together.
Through it all with us.
He was
that's
there.
That's a blessing, man. That's definitely a blessing.
He blessed the hands that kept did the surgery. He let everything come out right. We just got a healing process now, but we good. You see, we both standing tall, standing strong, but we good. You know what I'm saying? Out of my neck yet, but I'm good. You know what I'm saying?
We out of here. Last day. It's been a nice long process. You know, we had a lot of people around. It was very, you know, supportive.
Yeah.
You know, family and friends came through, our children, you know, everyone was, you know, great. And I love everybody who came out to support my mans and me through this process. You know, I thank all of y'all. And like I said, if you know somebody going through this situation,
if you can help,
help them.
Please help.
Go do what you can.
You know what I'm saying?
If you can't do nothing.
You can live your life with one kidney.
You can live it.
Long as you stay healthy. If you got high blood pressure or diabetes, just make sure you keep it under control and you can live the rest of your life with one kidney.
And if you healthy, you can help somebody get healthy.
Yes, you can.
You don't have to be like, well, I do thank God that I've never had any problems, but I thank God that he didn't give me any problems because he gave me opportunity to do this.
To help me.
To help somebody else. Had I had some problems, I might not have been able to help my brother.
You're right.
But I was healthy enough and faith, healthy in faith, and knowing that God has a mission and a plan for us, and this is what he wanted me to do, and I believe that Everything has a reason, and this was my reason, and if you have one too, find out what it is and help somebody.
I want to thank everybody for their kind words and all the prayers that went out. You know, we got so many people that I had so many people that called me that I didn't even know, left me messages on Facebook, Twitter, you know, praying for us, you know what I'm saying?
Some people getting checked.
You know, having kind words, man. But my whole thing is if you can help somebody to save another person's life, man, do it. You know what I'm saying? Do it. Because we got to stay together, man. We got to help each other, man. That's what we're here for.
And we are one of the leading people dying from hypertension.
Blacks.
Yes. But ain't nobody signing their back of their licenses to help nobody. They just dying.
They're just dying.
You know, yeah. And we can stop and make changes. Look out for each other. Look out for, you know, how we treat each other. How we respect each other, you know, and do for each other more.
I want to say this before I end. I was at dialysis before I came and we went in the hospital, and I was talking to a guy named Mr. Foster. He's 72 years old, and he told me, he was like, I had the opportunity to get 2 kidneys, and I turned them down. And I looked at him and I said, why would you do that? And he said, let me tell you something, son. I'm 72 years old. I done lived my life. Why would I get a kidney to live 4 or 5 more years when somebody else like you can get that kidney and live 30 years? That touched me.
100.
I said, wow, you would really let somebody else get their kidney because you done lived your life. And he said, I absolutely will. And I didn't take them kidneys, and I'm not. I'm going to live the rest of my life on dialysis. I look at him like he's a hero. Because somebody else would have took that kidney at 72 years old. You know what I'm saying? But he felt like somebody like me needed it before him. And that's some real shit, man. You know what I'm saying? If you can help, I can't stress it because I done been through it. If you can help anybody with donating them an organ or just signing your license when you die, that your organs can help somebody else, do it, man. Do it. Because trust me, it's somebody out there that need it. It's somebody out there right now that's on dialysis.
Right now.
That's suffering like I did for 2 years.
And
I know guys that's been on it a lot longer than me. You know what I'm saying?
Had the opportunity,
that haven't had the opportunity that I have. You know what I'm saying? Do it.
And I say this like I told him. I said, I didn't know anything about it, but since I've become an advocate for a donor, living donors, I noticed that I started meeting people, a lot more people that's sick and needs kidneys. And, you know, and it was so far from my, you know, just my living, just being around me, that now I walk into a room and I speak on it, it's someone in the room that needs that kidney. And had it not been for him, I'd have gave it to somebody else because I know people need it.
Right.
And you know, and I think, I know I'm not the only person out here like this. And there need to be more people like me like this.
Yes.
And maybe not, you know, they might be quieter about it, but we need to speak up and make more noise about helping people, period.
Help, period.
We got to help each other because I know you know somebody that's going through dialysis, hypertension, high blood pressure, that leads to kidney failure.
Diabetes.
Kidney failure, diabetes leads to death. Young people, we already don't have a high life expectancy as black men, but this is just something else that's killing us. And you know, we already have these things weighing up against us. Let's lighten up that load and make a change. This is my portion of making a change. I'm gonna make a change.
Right.
It starts right here. This is right here. It starts right here.
Right. Yeah. And it's not just that. It's just we need to get checkups, period. It's a lot of people that just walk around and you want to get their body checked out. You know what I'm saying? You should want to get your body checked out because you never know what's going on with you unless you go to the doctor and really find out. You know what I'm saying? You might either end up going to get a checkup and you might find out you got high blood pressure or, you know what I'm saying, just anything, man. We need to just get more checkups, get our body checkup, and take care of our health, man.
Take it from me. If you find out that you got high blood pressure,
do something.
Diabetes, do something about it.
Immediately.
Because you don't want to end up where I was at. Because you will. It will happen over time. It's, they call it the silent killer. You will be where I was at. And you don't want to be there. Because your life will change overnight. Taking dialysis is like a part-time job. You got to go there every day that they tell you to be there, and you got to be there for 5 or 6 hours plugged into a machine. My arm is disfigured from being stuck with all those needles all them for 2 years straight. You know what I'm saying? But I'm here. I'm blessed. I got my brother now. I got my life back. No more dialysis. All I got to do is take my meds and stay healthy. You know what I'm saying? Help the next man if you can. That's what this is about. This is not about him doing nothing for anything. It was about helping me. And it's about us trying to get y'all to help somebody if you can help somebody. You know what I'm saying? We as black people, we got to help each other. We got to start learning to stick together. You know what I'm saying?
It's easy for a person to take a life. You know how hard it is for one somebody to save one.
To give one.
You know, I got a son. My son. My son. And I want him to see that his daddy, this is what his daddy will do. So this is the example I want to send to my son. For him to send to his little brother. To him to send to his kids. Let him know, like, look, it ain't going to stop here. It's going to start here. This ain't going to stop here. It's going to start here. Right? It's gonna start right here with me, and all my family is gonna follow in this, because you know I'm gonna be an example, and I'm gonna lead by doing, not by talking about it. Don't talk about it. Do something. Do something. Don't talk about it. Do something.
All right.
That's his pops, man.
That's our pops.
Yeah, for life, man. Yeah.
You alright, bro? That's what's up. It's a blessing, man.
It's a blessing, definitely.
You
a
strong man. You everybody here, right?
A hero, definitely a hero.
A hero, man.
Exceptional individual.
He never definitely, once backed out on me. He never once. He was like, I'm there for you. I'm going to be there. He never once. I want to tell y'all our story. I want to tell you how we got to this point. One day I was telling him, we actually went out of town, and I did a song with Gucci Man, and on the way back, I had missed dialysis, and I started getting sick, and they wanted to take me to the hospital on the way home on our road trip,
right.
And I kept pushing, like, no, we're going to make it home.
And all like, we had to do was,
as long as we make it home, I'm going to make it to dialysis, and I'll feel a lot better. And he asked me about it. He was like, what is dialysis? Mm-hmm. And I started explaining to him what dialysis was. And I was telling him that I needed a kidney transplant. And you know what he said? He didn't hesitate. He was like, I'll give you a kidney. Well, a couple weeks went by. I didn't see him. And when I seen him, he was like, what happened? Did you make the appointment?
Yeah, I kept asking him. Like, how you didn't call and tell him?
I thought it was, you know, somebody tell you they're going to give you an organ, you think they bullshit. So I didn't even like really press the issue about it. Mm-hmm. I called, I made the appointment.
No, he bullshit about another week or so.
Yeah, I did, but I called and I made an appointment, and I called back and I told him. Told him the date and where he had to go.
One day,
I was at dialysis. I'll never forget it. He called me, he said, guess where I'm at? I said, where you at? He said, I'm on the bus. I said, where you going? I'm on the way to that appointment you told me about. I said, wow, he really going. A week went by. He called me on a Friday afternoon. He said, you ready to go celebrate? I said, celebrate what? I'm a match. I'm gonna give you that kidney that you need. And it's been an ongoing process ever since.
January.
Never backed out.
Since January.
It's been a 7 months, what, 10 months? Yeah. What is it's been 10 months. Eight months.
It might have been
10. 10, it's
been tough.
Because we had the insurance problems at first. Yeah. They found out that I smoked weed. I was being honest. I had a marijuana card, and they wanted to give us some problems, but he never backed out. He never missed an appointment. He was there. And through God's blessings, here I am. We had a successful operation. You know what I'm saying? I couldn't ask for much more. He saved my life. You know what I'm saying? When you're on dialysis, you have a shortened lifespan. You know, when you get that transplant, you get your life back. You know? He gave me 20, 30 more years of life to live again. You know what I'm saying? Other than that, I could be gone any day. You know what I'm saying? But shit. Right. I key you over here. I key you over here. You know what I'm saying? Right. Man, I love this man. I love him. You know what I'm saying? I love him. Anything I can do for
nothing
you.
Nothing but love.
All you gotta do is say. You know what I'm saying? And we there for each other.
Outside of the kidney, man, you know, I got love for mine. Yeah. I take care of all my family. And there ain't nothing I won't do for them. And I could do anything, I will do it. And I think everybody should feel like that about each other. Not just about your own loved ones, about each other.
Mankind.
Just mankind, period. You should love your brethren, not just your brother. Your brethren, period. You know what I'm saying? And in the Bible they said, there's nothing more greater than man can do than lay down his life for his brother.
That's it.
And if I can lead, like I said, by example, this is what I'm going to do. This example I want to leave for my son.
Yeah.
For my son.
He made me look at my life different. Now I feel like my life is to help someone else. He helped me. Now I got to take my life and I'm going to help someone else. If we all live like that, we have a better world. You know what I'm saying? If we can help someone live, do it. That's what it's about.
There you go. Amen to that, my friend.
It's nothing.
I almost lost my son when he was 17. And then when he called me one day, he said, "Mom, I have a young man that said he was going to give me a kitten." But then he called me and said, "Mom, when I got there, I didn't think he was going to even show." He said, "But he was there before me."
And I told him, I knew how Tree felt. I knew he wasn't going to.
And he said, "I really have."
You know, I knew. You know, it was. It's kind of unreal.
Sure.
Until we come down to that moment, you know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
Me and Tree talk and kick it all the time, but I knew that it really kicked in then.
Yeah.
When he was like, he down here at 6 o'clock in the morning to do this, he knew this.
And that was the next best thing to me. My mother was my aunt, and we lost her just before Shima came along and said, "They give her that." And the day he called me, he was so happy. He said, "Mom, but you ain't gonna believe this." And I said, "What, Tree?" He said, "He's a match." I didn't want to get my hopes up high because so many times people promise you something. And I've been let down so much in life depending on others. I didn't even think about it. I just kept on praying. And then when it happened, that was the happiest thing in my life. It's a half children. My life, I always wanted 2 children, but I always wanted a boy and a girl. But sometimes God put other people in your life, and he didn't see fit for that girl. He seemed fit for me to have another son. All right. I'm Shema, whatever. My doors are always open, not only to you, your children, and your family, because you didn't have to. And most people nowadays, when they want some, people put price tags on things. And you could have been one of those that said, "No, I want to sell my kidney," but you didn't do that. You did not do that at all. And when I came to you, I said, "What you need?" Every time I offered Shima something, he didn't want it. It was like, "No, Mom, no, Mom, no, Mom."
And I just want to thank you, Shima. I want to thank your father, because your father could have been one that sometimes I work with the public, and people can be so mean.
And listen, it's funny that you say that, because, you know, I didn't know how my father was going to respond to me telling him that. But my father hugged me and said, man, that's a blessing. You're going to be great for doing that.
Yeah.
You know, and he know me, and I got a giving heart, period. Mm-hmm. But, you know, that was like, you know, 10 times more than what I was thinking I'd ever thought I would do myself for anybody. Mm-hmm. But I was like, you know, I'm going to do it. And it's not going to be nothing about it. It's going to be good. Mm-hmm. All good things come to good people. And as long as, I mean, because I know I'm going to do right by people. People ain't always going to do right by me. Mm-hmm.
That's
but that's not, I'm not going to stop being
who you are.
Man, who I am. Right. For nobody. Yeah. Right. I'm always.
Like when you told me, I said, well, wasn't nothing negative I could say about it. I said, this is what God put on your heart to do. So regardless to what anybody else thinks, and it's been a lot of negative talk.
A lot of negative talk around definitely. Me and my family.
Yeah, it's been a lot of negative talk. But late, I said, like, listen, you know, this is what God, this is God's plan. You understand?
What he giving you.
Right.
What, you know, yeah, what is all right. Right. What this ain't about that. It's not about, it's not about monetary things. It's about, I want to give him something.
Yeah. Right. You want to be the giver. Right. And that's
I want to give somebody something.
And that's what the Bible says. It's better to give than to receive.
Yes, it is.
And you prove that you have faith in that and you believe that.
I believe that.
You believe
it. You know, and I'm always continue to give.
Yeah.
And I want my son to see me.
Right.
Be that
right.
Man.
Yeah.
And when I die. Yeah. You gonna talk about it like my daddy was that type of guy. Yeah. You know, my daddy was a real one.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? He didn't give it to anybody.
That's it.
Man, it's just a blessing, you know. Like I said, I get my life back.
This is crazy. This is crazy.
I've been through a lot in my life. I got shot when I was 17. I damn near lost my life then. You know, they removed my first kidney when I was 17 years old. And it's been all downhill ever since. You know, I developed high blood pressure and diabetes over the years. And it wiped my kidney up. You know, overnight I became on dialysis, and man, that's like, I can't even talk to you how bad it is being on dialysis. When you get on dialysis, your lifespan go from here to here. You know, they don't expect you to make it stand on dialysis. You know what I'm saying? But now I got my kidney back. I'm feeling great. Pressure down. Everything is working well. Like I said, my kidney was functioning before I even made it out the recovery room. Before I even came through, my kidney was functioning. That was a blessing. I just watched a lady get a transplant a week before I did. But she had a cadaverous kidney. And she had to go back to dialysis. I'm blessed. I don't have to go back. Just got to take care of myself, take my meds, and stay in shape. And eat right. You know what I'm saying? It's a blessing, man. It's a blessing.
Wow. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you for your goodness, your love, and your mercy. Father, we ask that this will never be forgotten. Bless all in our prison and those who are not. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Wow. Look at y'all up. Ready to go.
Yes. This is my cousin, Nikki. You know, she works
right here. Ready to go, Nikki.
Y'all feeling okay? Ready to go?
We feel good.
No pain?
Nothing? No, I'm a little tight.
What's to be expected?
Yeah.
What's to be expected?
Nothing we can't handle.
Nothing I can't handle.
Say what?
That's some real shit Shima did, man.
Right.
You know, he never hesitated, though. That was the crazy part about it. Once he found out what it was, you know, and what I needed, he, from day one, he was like, I'm there. I got you. Never backed out on me. Never missed the appointment. You know, it's something he didn't have to do. But he chose to do it. He chose to help me. I'll be forever grateful for that, man. You know?
Yeah.
Like I said, you know, it's for me, You know, it makes me want to help somebody else. You know what I'm saying? Exactly. Even if I don't do nothing but get somebody to be aware to, you know, help somebody else, then I feel like I did my job. You know what I'm saying? Because he didn't have to do that shit, man. He didn't ask me for nothing. You know what I'm saying? That's why I feel like I'm in debt to him. You know what I'm saying?
It's just, he probably just doing it to be real, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, that's friends out there.
He did it from the kindness. Did it from the kindness of his heart. Yeah. You know I'm a good guy.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You know I ain't out here hurting, killing nobody, or trying to take nothing from nobody. You know?
And when people realize money suffering. And everything, money and
he
everything.
He wanted to help me, and he did. Yeah. I can't ask much more, man. The best gift of life I ever had.
Yeah.
You know? Best gift, man. I get my life back. The dialysis, I ain't gonna lie, dog. I don't wish that on my best enemy. To go through what I had to go through, man. It takes a lot out of you. It takes a lot of your time. You know, one thing I gotta do is stay healthy and take my medicine every day.
Yeah.
Eat right, you know what I'm saying? Be a little more physical. You know what I'm saying? Do some walking or some running. You know what I'm saying? That's all I gotta do. And I should be good.
Yeah. Mom, how you feel? I see you got a little breather. Feel a little bit better. Just smile just a little bit bigger, Mom.
Yes, I feel 100% better. So knowing that I got my son back.
That's what's up.
People just don't know how many nights I walked that floor, even though my son didn't know. Go to work with a smile. People never know what a smile, what another person is going through or what they have been through.
Exactly.
I never complain to anyone at my job because people have their own problems. And when you have problems, sometimes people treat you at your worst when they know you at your lowest. I kept my head up. I kept prayed up. Even though I might not talk to my son, because when I would talk to my son didn't want me to worry about him. I found out more about how my son was doing by other people that would tell me that my son wasn't feeling good.
So, me not knowing,
yeah.
I mean, the whole time that we going through and all the time he's telling me he's coming down here and Shimma was giving it to him, I had to keep saying, Lord, let this work. You already know what I've been through. You already know what my son been through. And I always felt that what my son was going through, he should have.
I'm happy. I'm so happy.
That's what's up, man. Yes. You officially have a new son now?
I have not only a son, I have some grandchildren.
Oh, yeah.
Also. Right. So I no longer have the two. I have, well, she might have three. So that's five.
Right.
Five grandchildren. Even though I always wanted a girl, so I wound up with the one granddaughter. So that's fine.
Right.
That's fine. I'm happy. I'm very happy.
It's definitely a blessing. God definitely blessed you. You still have your son, and he's in good health.
Yes. And I know my face looked like, what the world happened? But my face, a tear of joy. I've been crying, and every time I talk about it, tears start flowing because God has been good.
Yes.
He's really been good to me, my son, and all his friends has been just great. I mean, you see people in the streets one way, but you don't know how they're going to be in another way, but I have to say that a lot of his friend has God in them, and they know the power of prayer. And I want to thank everybody that has helped him and to help us get through this together.
It's like, I know you feel good right now.
I do. I'm just thankful. Please, I'm done. I'm not a camera person.
Yep.
And he's up, out. This is a miracle.
Oh, he's out walking.
He's out walking, no pain medicine. I mean, this is nothing but God.
Just like I said, my stomach kind of tight.
All right, I got everything.
So you straight, though?
I took care of
her. So you about to bust up?
Going home, man. I ain't seen my house since Wednesday. I ain't seen my throne since Tuesday. I'm gonna go sit on my own throne. Try to get it in.
You know, I got my son, he gonna take care of me. My girl, she gonna watch out for me. Can't get all the Bible now. And I'm, like I say, I'm blessed, man. It came through successful, no hitches, no nothing. Everything is good. I'm glad about it. And the people here at Harper Hospital were amazing. Amazing. My surgeons, my the team, everybody was great. Treated me well, made me comfortable. Right, I'd hate to go, but I gotta go. But yeah, everything has been great, man. It's been a hell of a emotional roller coaster, and I'm looking forward to just getting back to regular things, you know, just regular life, and you know, like I said, just continue to be an advocate for people who need to donate, and look out and help people. You know what I'm saying? I want people to know that they should help other people.
There you go.
You know, that's it. That's it. That's what I'm doing. So, anything else I need to put out there? Shout out to 99.9 Almost Too High. Shout out to B, Miss B from the D, come through, you know what I'm saying? Shout out to all my peoples on the east side, west side, love me, all y'all haters. You're gonna always hate. You're gonna always hate. That's all you do. That's what you do, hating. You know what I'm saying? I know you didn't want me to do this, but look at me.
Same.
Still here.
All right.
Still here. Still kicking. Still standing.
Still standing.
You know what I'm saying? And without you, I'll do it. Holla.
Okay. Take care.
All right. I'll see you, sir.
Take care. See you later.
Okay. All right. Hey, if you know somebody that need to talk to somebody
about what?
Being an advocate. Tell them to call me. I'll be up here to talk to them.
Okay. When you get that survey, 5 stars.
All right.
That's right.
All right, yeah. Okay. Oh, my goodness. That hurt. Yeah.
Okay. So, I gave the gift of life.
This right here means I gave the gift of life. And this is half of it. And the receiver of my gift is gonna have, I received the gift of life. And I wanna see these on a lot of people. And I don't wanna be the only one with one of these. So we gonna try to see if we can get this on a lot of people. And help people. And you know, I thank y'all, you know what I'm saying, for everything. Appreciate that.
Coming out. Last day in the hospital.
Last day.
Short of kids.
We're outside again, yeah, brother.
I ain't seen outside, so.
You feel like you like that?
Hey, did this grow great
while I was there? I don't know why. I ain't been stressing.
But you know,
this ain't grow, man.
Yeah. Oh, he said when he was in the shower, this spot back here is really missing something.
He
said he could feel it, left side.
Your left side.
He said he could feel it, that like it's not it, there, a void.
Like it's hollow. Okay.
Like I'm missing something here.
Yeah, okay.
Because when my body tighten up, I can see my muscle tighten up under my rib.
Like it
cuts.
Yeah.
Okay.
And it hurt.
But your body got to build back up, you know.
I'm going to build it back up. Yeah. Like I said, but I got to take my time.
Yeah.
I'll get back to it.
Definitely
going to
take
some
time.
At least you feel good, though, you know?
Yeah, I'm good, man. I'm glad to be out in front of the sun.
Yeah, man.
With some sunlight.
Summertime,
you know. Go home, check on my house. Go see my baby boy. Yeah, go see my son. You know, so I ain't seen him in a week. And everything be good. Catch up with my homeboys. Glad they came through, man.
Yeah, you know, I come through to represent them.
I'm glad. I love my dogs. You know what I'm saying? They're here. And I'm good.
All right,
man. Thanks, for real. Like I said, we gonna spread this. We gonna spread this on and keep it going. This will not stop here. Today is not the last day. Today is the first day of the rest of this.
You know, I'm recovering, but this is the first day of the rest of this application thing. We are going to get people involved.
So they tell them to stay tuned.
Yeah, stay tuned. Stay close, because we coming to a neighborhood near you. We're going to be at your store. We're going to be at your store. We're going to be at your school. We're going to be at your college. We're going to be at your dialysis. We're going to tell people, we're going to go to the people at these dialysis and tell them, we have somebody that wants to give you a kidney. They going to help you. You don't have to worry about it no more. All right, I'm out of here.
Get your phone, baby.
All right, Pops.
You good, baby?
Yeah, love you. Yeah. Good, cuz. Take your time. See you back soon. Raise your window down. Yeah. All right, brother, man.
All right.
See you in a minute.
See you on the other side.
I'll be over there.
All right.
Need me to cook something or you good?
Huh?
Need me to cook something or you good?
You know what? I'm going to have to do something. But I'm about to go get a whip. Go pick up the whip and do some grocery shopping. Get some different things. I'm gonna have to eat some slight changes. I'm gonna make in my diet
right.
While I'm recovering. You know what I'm saying? I want to get back into old habits. We gotta make some changes.
Yeah.
Real talk. We gonna make some changes.
Yeah.
We all make.
Just like
some
Obama
changes.
Makes some changes.
Yeah. We gonna make some changes.
That's what's up, man.
All right.
In a minute.
Have a good one.
Drive safe, Pops. Deuce.
My last day. About to go get on this elevator. I'm going home. You know, blessed,
right.
Feel good, you know, just nothing but, you know, blessings right now.
Right.
Like I said, I want to thank everybody for their prayers and their kind words and shit. Y'all will be seeing me soon, you know?
Healthier as ever.
Healthier than ever. I'm back 100.
That's what's
I'm
up.
Back, baby.
That's what's up.
Hey, what's that pen you got right there?
This from my brother. He got the other half. He gave me the other half. You know, this means he gave me a part of life. He gave me a part of his life. I got a part of his organs in me. So that means I'm gonna keep this the rest of my life.